In this video I'm going to showcase the highest DPS builds in the game that I know of. I am showcasing 4 builds. 1 mage and 3 strength. So for the first build I'm going to showcase. These are the accessories, but this one in particular you can swap in or out with anything you feel like. It deals up to 50% increased damage when under 50% HP, but there's something called the unharmed energy you can get which deals 15% more damage at max, which is great for percentage stacking. I'm going to show you quickly kind of how to proc the sanguine ring, which is the accessory I said you could swap out. So this is the current damage hero with full rampage and combo glove plus sneak attack. Some damage can argue not to be true, but it's still a way to compare high amounts of damage to other weapons. This also isn't full potential. You take the highest crit being 751 then add 50% to it, which brings your most peak damage being 1200. This isn't just really good to flex damage on dummies, but it also is really consistent and heals a lot if you have the exact build with Vampire. With the same build I'm using a Tanto as my secondary weapon because the built-in crit chance and speed for quick DPS on lower HP mobs. For my ranged I'm using a Shroomerang, which is great for bosses because you can maintain distance and deal out good damage. The next build is a Halicide build which deals amazing burst damage. There's a lot of accessories you can swap, but I'll show you the ones I use and recommend. So here you can swap the helmet, and you can use different accessories to amplify the bleed such as Royal Antenna or the Rusty accessories. So here's what I decided to settle with. Like I said, you can swap the rubber band or the shark tooth necklace for something of your choice. You could even equip more crit accessories so you don't need to have lucky attribute on the weapon itself, and then you could get something like sharp for plus 15% damage. As you can see I'm one-shotting the dummies and dealing over 1000 damage, but that's without the sanguine ring. I'd also like to mention the first build I showcased does have more damage being around 1.6k at most with sneak attack, critical hit with your mouse to attack with sanguine. This next build you can swap the helmet, but not much else. You could get the mini squid from Mondo Squid which makes you do insane damage at low HP with sanguine ring and covering the enemy in the oil while dousing yourself in flames to use your crit. You deal the most damage out of the 3 builds with this one, but the problem is that it isn't consistent and also tedious to play, so here's me hitting the dummies. As you can see the DPS isn't as much as the first two, but this is a very poor way to showcase the damage. There is a YouTuber called Lord Sendo who made this build. He didn't use that good of accessories in my opinion, but he showcases the squid. So for the last build I'm going to showcase a really fun mage build that depends on the enchant. Here is the armor here. I recommend highly to not use combo glove, but instead diamond ring or maybe some dex or defense accessories. Play around with that slot. What you want to do is utilize the mana blade to restore the mana really fast and use your wicked limb staff to deal damage from afar. Once you get low on mana, go in with your mana blade crit and restore all the mana. This is not only really fun to play, but you can also just purely use the raw damage from the mana blade to melt the mobs you are fighting.
Like damn, she in her mood. She lit, get money too. Like damn, she in her mood. In the mirror, I'm doing my dance.